Oh, right. Is he dying? Is it a poet in a diving bell? Is it really sad and weird, but soon he'll be gone?
No, we've been together for a number of years, and we are committed and in love.
Oh, shit.
I'm so sorry, Jez. I just thought you and me would be one night of fun. And then I got sucked in, and we got serious, and Gail was away traveling.
Gail? As in, a woman? This love rival is a chick?
Yeah. Are you disgusted? Is that a problem for you?
£2,000. Oh, God, the Halifax top savers account is finally dry. The last of the Corrigan millions.
Mark, you dick! You've got it all wrong again.
Hello? What?
Everything's going to be fine. The other guy is a woman. They're both two women.
So it doesn't bother you, her being in a relationship with someone else?
Well, a bit, but basically, not really. I mean, me and this Gail, we're just eating from different sides of the plate. I play woodwind, she's on brass.
But Elena's betrayed you. How does it make a difference that it's with another woman?
Because it's hot. I mean, even a dried up, desiccated old bran flake on toast like you should be able to see that.
If I'm a bran flake, he's a slutty sugar puff.
Ugh, can't really take more than one lengthy toilet break per morning. The downtime here is non-existent.
Anything?
I'm sorry?
In the loo. How did it go?
You want to know if I...
Ideas, leads, pitches. Did you not come up with anything?
I was on the loo, Alan.
Oh, can you just keep it down a bit?
Listen, I've ordered up 1,000 business cards. I hope you don't mind, but I had to make a call on the name.
Oh, fine. I like them both. Which did you go for, Consultio or Consultius?
Consultio / Consultius.
How do you mean?
God's sake!
I wonder if Mrs. Sugar's allowed to sleep in the boardroom.
The name is Consultio / Consultius. Got both bases covered. I've got our cover letter ready to print up.
Right, and as of now, Alan, how many solid contracts or leads do we actually have?
That's for me to know and you to find out. Print, you damnable fudger.
Maybe there's a connection problem. Alan, the printer's not connected.
No, it's wireless.
It's not wireless. It doesn't say wireless. It needs wires. Shall I say, or live in his dream world?
Screw it. Sort it later. Stick it on the later base.
Good, I'm sure it'll work. Later.
Hello.
Mark, tell him I'm going out.
Where?
Anywhere. Milk.
And scotch tape it, buddy. Where'd Suze go?
To get milk.
But we already have milk.
I don't think it's really about the milk.
Well, what is it about, Mark, if you're the big expert? I know she's seeing someone. Is it that guy from the Smeg oven shop or the monk she's emailing?
I don't know.
Oh, you don't know? Well, then maybe you should keep your trap shut if you don't actually know. Did that occur to you? So, when are your 2,000 notes going to make their appearance?
Oh, yeah, right. Soon.
Don't tell him it's in my pocket. Tell him it's not in my pocket?
Although I was wondering whether in the current climate it'll be possible to recoup such a big investment in terms
of... Relax, Mark. You've seen this from the Sales Direct guys. They say they look forward to hearing from us in the future. They look forward to it. Now, what about that doesn't spell to you serious interest?
Right.
Just keep nodding and smiling. Nodding and smiling like Colonel Gaddafi's psychoanalyst.
It's great, isn't it? Having an affair.
It is exciting. Like this morning when you called and I thought, oh, hell. But then I told Gail you were someone else and she bought it. It was totally mad.
Yeah, mad, mad shit.
Bugs, Gail. Just follow my lead.
Heading for a threesome, a sexy lesbo threesome.
I thought you were going from the restaurant straight to your Mensa party.
Yeah, shirt too much. Shit, do I possibly look a total dick here?
Who's,
Oh, he's just getting some dope. Jeremy Gale.
Hi, how you doing?
Good. Just another local pothead. That's me. I live upstairs, buy the pot here, take it there. That's my system. If you can call it a system.
Cool.
You should go. She'll sniff us out. She's in Mensa. She's a genius.
Okay, well, see you around. Neighbour? Not so clever now I'm humping your girlfriend, are you? You might be a big Mensan, but you haven't figured that one out, eh? Bye. It's perfect. Happy birthday, Elena.
Where's real Elena? Aren't you cooking her a birthday breakfast?
She texted to say she couldn't make it. Gail took the morning off work and surprised her.
Ah, right. How's the affair going?
Good. Yeah, it's hot. We were going to watch The Wrestler last night, but she'd already seen it with Gail, so we watched Grand Designs, and then Gail came home, and so I had to leave. But yeah, pretty hot.
Right. Great. Tell you what, shall I make us both some pancakes?
Actually, man, that would be really nice. Ugh. Big Suze. She keeps leaving these endless messages saying about how pissed off she is with Johnson and how he goes around writing his name on all the fruit, and if she accidentally eats a Johnson orange, then he totally loses it. How's it going with Consultiarium?
Brilliant. Yeah, great. And one good thing is I'm worrying quite a lot of the time whether Johnson isn't totally losing his nut.
Really?
Yeah. I look at him sometimes now and think, you know, has Daddy's hat fallen off?
Daddy's hat?
Yes. Has Daddy's hat fallen off? And he's just standing there, naked.
I don't know.
He'll probably be fine.
Mark, maybe scratch the pancakes? Girl's gone out to Pilates. I've got a window.
You've been summoned.
Exactly. Back to the coalface. Right, okay. Keys, condoms, present. Okay, off to my affair. See you later.
Show me the money, Mark. What am I going to do? Is it going to be okay? It doesn't feel okay. He seems mental.
And that's the front room, naturally.
Jez, why are they...
Relax. It's just a couple of neighbours come down to have a chat about you getting a job in a Mexican restaurant.
What? No, Jeremy!
Gail walked in out of the blue again, and I thought, wouldn't it be great if you were to track her movements for me?
What?
So you're the guy who wants to work in a Mexican restaurant?
Yep. Yes, he is. Sign him up. Right, booze. Oh, I don't believe it. I've forgotten to get booze.
I'm not a big drinker anyway, so...
Nonsense. I'll pop to the offie. And, Elena, you wanted me to remind you about the thing?
The thing?
Elena, remember? You said, my car's on pay and display, please remind me. So I'm just reminding you.
Oh, yeah, right.
I'll walk you down.
Well, you two get along great. Gail's a genius.
I'm not a genius, I just have a very high IQ. I'm a Mensen.
It means she's very perceptive. She spots things that other people miss. She's very highly attuned.
Great. I'm the fuck pie's pastry crust. I'm holding all the disgusting ingredients together.
There's always room at Banditos for an English-speaking gunslinger.
I'm not sure I need to sink to washing up just yet.
It's £100 a shift with tips. You could try a shift and see.
Oh,
maybe I could juggle it. Johnson by day, Bandito by night. Rich Mark could give to poor Mark. I could be the Zorro of myself.
That could be interesting.
The timing's quite good, actually, because I've got a couple of staff who are moving on. And
me and E go in bed at hers. Keep Gail sweat.
You can shoot up
Finks
really quickly.
Jez. Oh, so, God.
Great, call me at the restaurant. You tell E I've grabbed an early one.
Don't go. Stay.
Why?
Why?
Why? Why, she asks. Yes, why?
Because I've got one or two questions. For instance, delineate for me, if you can, the main points of difference between the...